Reading from the book of Jeremiah. I have been listening. But everything that John said about this man was true. And many believed in him there. The Gospel of the Lord. As we draw closer to Holy Week and closer to Good Friday, we begin to see that hatred was grown toward Jesus. Just as we saw in yesterday's Gospel, this makes no sense. To hate Jesus and to desire to stone him to death is an act of the greatest irrationality. But this is what happened. Little by little, those who were against Jesus grew in boldness until the ultimate day came when he laid down his life for us and willingly embraced death. Over the next 2 weeks, it's good to face this irrationality and persecution head on. It's good to see the hatred of so many and to name it for what it is. No, it's not a pleasant thought, but it is reality. It's the world we live in, and it's a reality we will all face in our lives. When confronting evil and persecution, we should do so as Jesus did. He faced it without fear. He faced it with the truth and never accepted the lies and calumny that so many threw at him. The fact of the matter is that the closer we grow toward God, the greater the persecution and hatred we will encounter. Again, this may not make sense to us. It's easy to think that if we are close to God and strive for holiness, everyone will love and praise us. But it wasn't that way for Jesus, and it will not be that way for us either. One key to holiness is that in the midst of persecution, suffering, hardship, and sorrow, we stand firm in the truth. It's always tempting to think that we must be doing something wrong when things do not go our way. It's easy to be confused by the lies and calumny that the world throws at us when we try to stand for goodness and for truth. One thing God wants of us, in the midst of our own crosses, is to purify our faith and resolve to stand firm in his word and truth. When we face some cross or some persecution, it can be like getting hit in the head. We may feel like we are in a daze and can give into panic and fear. But these are the times, more than any other, when we need to stand strong. We need to remain humble, but deeply convicted about all that God has said and revealed to us. This deepens our ability to trust God in all things. It's easy to say we trust God when life is easy. It's hard to trust them when the cross we face is quite heavy. Think about the fact that no matter what your cross may be, it is a gift from God in that He is designed to strengthen you for some greater purpose. As St. John Paul the Great said over and over during his pontificate, do not be afraid. Face your fears and let God transform you in the midst of them. If you do so, you'll discover your greatest struggles in life actually turn out to be your greatest blessings. The Lord is a rock and a stronghold. From Him He hears the voice of those who call upon His name. We remember in prayers those who do not know God, or whose God is too small. Lord, hear us. We remember in prayer those who champion the rights of the needy and the oppressed. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We remember in prayer those who take refuge not in God, but in alcohol or drugs. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
We remember in prayer those of our community in need, the sick, the lonely, the unemployed, and those in any kind of trouble. Lord, hear us. Father, be with us as we prepare for the Easter festival. Listen to our prayers, those spoken out loud, those in the silence of our hearts, and grant all we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness to the sea reign upon you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have seen the wine of you, fruit of vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual bread.
Which will be poured out for you and for me,
for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me.
Thank you. Thank you. Let us pray. May the unfading protection of the sacraments we receive never leave us alone, and may it always drive far from us all that would do us harm, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
your spirit. Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Grant we pray, Almighty God, that your servants who seek the grace of your protection may be free from every evil and serve you in peace of mind. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Saint Michael the Archangel, defend us in the hour of battle. Be our protection against wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke and we humbly pray. And be our own prince of the heavenly host. By the power of God, thrust down into God, Satan and all the evil spirits, who wander through the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Let us peace in new number 476, number 476.